In my book, Compost Everything, I have a chapter dedicated to composting toilet systems. Now, composting toilets are one of those things that are kind of terrifying because nobody really wants to deal with that sort of thing. And if they do, they're probably insane. However, they are very useful if you've got an off-grid type of a setup, or if you're just an absolute extreme composter and you can't stand the fact that some potential soil fertility is literally being flushed away. So, after reading Joseph Jenkins' Humanure Handbook, I decided to build a simple composting toilet back when I lived in Tennessee. We had a little house. It was a 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom house. And the bathroom was kind of a wreck because it had rotted out, and so we put in a composting bucket toilet system in the house and completely ignored codes and all that nonsense. And I didn't write about it back then because I didn't actually want to have my house raided and be arrested or whatever nonsense people might do if they knew that you were an extreme composter. And the composting toilet was used, and then in the backyard, I had an old refrigerator. And you probably saw my refrigerator garden. I have a penchant for recycling refrigerators. But this refrigerator sat in the very back corner of the yard. It had a little bit of drainage nailed into it. I put it on its back and put drainage in it. And then around it, I dug a trench so, like, if there was a flooding rain or something like that, it wouldn't turn around and become a big public health crisis if it leaked. But really, the key to it is not just dumping the contents of a toilet in there, but to have a lot of fill material. During the year, I had all of this material that I would gather, particularly in fall, that I would use as carboniferous material to absorb what was coming out of the composting toilet. Now, the composting toilet was using, you could use sawdust in it as a fill, and I had shredded wood chips from the city that I used, which were not all that good. They didn't cover the material as well as you would like. Sawdust seems to be the best, but you know, we were using what we had and there wasn't a sawmill near where we lived. So we used this mulched up like wood chips, the stuff that the power companies would shred along the power lines, and I used that as a fill material. And I had an entire dump truck of it dumped into my backyard, so it was really good to use. So we would take this bucket of waste, and I would go in the backyard and I would dump it into this refrigerator. And in the refrigerator, I had all kinds of other carbon material in the bottom. So when I dumped it in, I would cover it quickly. I also saved all of the fall leaves from the neighborhood. Like, people would put those big bags by the side of the road full of leaves. And I was like, hey, there we go. There's some carboniferous material. And I use those in my gardens, but I also kept like 40 or 50 bags of them and would just go through them as the year progressed. And then when fall came, I would do it again. We would dump the bucket in there and then cover it up. And I kind of hid it back in the bushes. We were in a neighborhood, a suburban neighborhood, and I hid it back in the bushes, and it would digest those buckets. We probably filled about a bucket a week, and then we would dump that bucket back there and then, you know, repeat the process. But what I didn't realize is that whatever enzymes are in our digestion or whatever that manure is, there's something to it that makes compost really, really hot and impressive. Like that compost pile would go all the way through the winter. And I mean, it would get freezing cold outside, there'd be snow on the ground, there'd be ice and everything else, and the compost would still be cooking. So there was something about it that was really kicking, and it was always kicking. Like, I put in an entire chicken carcass and it was gone in like a couple of days. There was just little bits of bones. It was just constantly cooking. It was like, I called it the digester, because anything you threw in there was gone. And who knows why, but a humanure composting system seems to really, really digest everything quite well. Now, another thing we did was I added red wiggler worms to it. They used to be called Isenia foetidae, I think, or foetidae or whatever. They've changed the Latin name on it again, and I've forgotten what it is. But it's the red wigglers, or the tiger worms, or the composting worms, or whatever you want to call them. I introduced those to the edge of this system, and they lived very happily in that refrigerator, and they did not freeze to death. I didn't keep the lid on the fridge instead, because I thought it was a little bit dangerous, so instead I put a piece of plywood on top, and I put some cinder blocks on top of it to hold it. And we just like go out there, dump the bucket in there, and I had some water out there, and I had some soap out there, and I had a scrub brush. And I would just like rinse out the inside of the bucket like Joseph Jenkins recommends, and then throw that bucket into the system, and then I would leave those out there in the sun for the day to be sterilized by UV, but they'd already been washed, so it was safe. Now, there were times when it was cold outside and it was just not a good time to go and empty the buckets, like the neighbors having a picnic or something like that. So In that case, I had lids for the buckets and I could just seal them. And at some points, I actually sealed multiple buckets from there and I would just store them until there was a good time to do like three or four of them at once instead of having to go out there every week and do it. So this was how we had our composting toilet system. And it worked. At that point, I think I had three or four children and it worked. It's no big deal. Sometimes we had like, we would go through the buckets quicker, like we had parties and that sort of thing and people come over to visit, but most of the time it was like one bucket a week. And if you had a cabin or something like that, a system like that would be really good. Another thing you can do if you want to compost the stuff instead of having to really like make a compost pile and collect all the carbon material and that sort of thing is just to dig pits or trenches and dump it into those trenches and then later plant on top of it, because whatever you plant there is going to do absolutely wonderfully. What about using the compost that we made? Well, the way we used it was we would wait a year. Like, I stopped composting in that big refrigerator and just waited. I didn't perpetually feed it. What I did was I created like another compost bin next to it with pallets and boards that I had, like scrap stuff that I had. And at the end of a year, I emptied all of the stuff out of the main refrigerator digester and dumped them into a big pile next to it. And there was no smell. It was like earthy and fine looking stuff, but I gave it some time. And then like the next year's garden, I took all of that and just went ahead and put it into the garden beds and put it around my fruit trees. And we grew the most amazing crop of tomatoes that I think I've ever grown in my entire life with that material. But it's not the sort of thing you're like, oh, by the way, do you know what I fed these tomatoes with? No, it's better to like a don't ask, don't tell type of a thing. It's not the sort of thing that really people mostly get all that excited about, except for very, very strange people who write about it in their books. But that's our experience with composting toilets, and I used it as a test in part to see what would happen if like centralized plumbing was destroyed and the water treatment center went down. I was really prepping at that point and trying to run scenarios and do experiments that later I would write about, and it ended up being a chapter of Compost Everything. And you can find the book on Amazon if you're interested and read the entire story along with a bunch of other stuff on composting. But that's it. That's my composting toilet, and yes, it did work, and no, it wasn't that big a deal to maintain. Sometimes the system would smell a little bit if you didn't have enough material, like if you were not using sawdust. It's just not quite as good a cover. If you have sawdust on it, and if you cover the stuff really well every time the toilet's used, that works really well. But there's another problem, like if you have children and they're using the system and you've got sawdust, the sawdust like ends up all over your bathroom, so it's always like a sawmill inside of your house. So that's the downside of it. Sometimes it smells, sometimes you get sawdust. Occasionally we had like little outbreaks of, they weren't like the nasty flies, but they were like some sort of little tiny weeny gnats that showed up. And when that happened, man, everything was dumped out into the system. Buckets were washed out and all that stuff. And we would just restart it. But there it is. That's what we did. And it works. And if you had a off-grid cabin or you wanted to really, really recycle everything and you didn't want to waste all that potential soil fertility and you wanted to grow some really good tomatoes, Joseph Jenkins Systems works. I'll put a link in the description to his book, The Humanure Handbook. And if anybody has any other stories they want to share, go ahead and post them in the comments. There are easier systems than this, like Biolet and Sunmar, and my friend Sandy, who has the Boon John system. That's a very simple, affordable method, and he's got great gardens that he grows on it. I'll put a link to Boon John as well, and check it out in the description. And until next time, may your thumbs always be green.
Yeah. Yeah. Get a little bit crazy up in here, Joe Jenkins style. You can compost everything, including your own waste. was kinda crazy and it ain't in good taste. If you're going off grid, you know it's a darn good option. Just be sure you're not armed when the cops bust your door in. Turning all that stuff right back into the earth, then your tomatoes will go insane with their weight in their girth. If you're not afraid, you get paid in fertility and you get a black belt in composting ability. Give it a try and see your garden sing, and check out my book, Compost Everything.